everyone, welcome back to my channel, Get Fit with Court. Today is a special on water. I'll be giving you 6 reasons why water is so important for your body, and I'll be explaining how much you need to take in every day. Then at the end of the video, I'll be giving you a few recipes on how to infuse your water, so stay tuned. Water helps control calorie intake and sugar intake. So if you're a big soda drinker or juice drinker and you replace half of those with water, then you're going to be taking out half of those calories and half of the sugar that you take in every day. Also, a lot of people feel like they're hungry all the time or they always get cravings. A lot of the times you're not really hungry and you're just dehydrated. Your body may mix those signals up. So if you're drinking enough water, you might not get as many of those cravings and always feel hungry like that. Water helps energize your muscles. If your muscle cells don't have enough water, they're not going to work as well. So you won't be able to get as much out of your workouts. If you go to the gym and you find yourself getting tired or your body hurting, it's probably because you're slightly dehydrated. So it's often recommended that you drink at least 20 ounces of water before your workouts so you can get the most out of your workouts while you're losing so much water because you're sweating. So you need to have that water replaced and you need to be drinking water throughout your workout so you won't get dehydrated. For your kidneys to work properly, they need an adequate amount of fluids to transport the toxins out of your body. And if those fluids aren't there, then those toxins stay in your body. So you need enough water to transport those toxins out so your kidneys can do their job and get the toxins out of your body. Water helps maintain the balance of your bodily fluids. So your body is made up of about 60% water. And those fluids are needed to perform bodily functions like digestion, absorption, body temperature, circulation, and transportation of nutrients. So if your body doesn't have enough water, then those functions aren't going to be able to be performed correctly and accurately because your body just doesn't have the means to perform those functions. So you need to drink water to have those functions carried all the way out. Your skin contains a lot of water, so if you are dehydrated, your skin is going to look dry and more wrinkled than it would if you were taking in the amount of water that you need to take in every day. And also, a lot of people say that their skin looks more glowy when they have been drinking a lot of water, and it helps with acne. If you have skin problems, it helps clear up your face. So drinking enough water for your skin is definitely beneficial. Lastly, water helps the flow in your gastrointestinal tract. So if you have a hard time, you know, going to the bathroom, you need to drink some more water so you're not constipated, because it will definitely help with that and get the toxins out, you know, the waste out of your body. A lot of people feel like the amount of water they need to drink every day is just too much and it's impossible. However, it's not that hard. And I have a way of breaking it down so you guys can figure out how much you need to take in every day. So, I weigh 130 pounds. If I take that and divide it by 2, which is 65, and then turn that into ounces, 65 ounces, that's how much water I need to drink every day. So how I keep track of that, I buy a water bottle that has the calculations on the side. I mean the measurements on the side. So you see, that's 32 ounces all the way at the top. And then they have them all the way down the side. So I need to drink 2 of these every day. But if you don't want to buy one of those bottles, I got that from Walmart for like $2. You can just get a regular water bottle. And this is 20 ounces, so for me, I would need to drink about 4 of these, 4 and a little bit. this recipe, you just need raspberry, some fresh mint, some cut up lemon, and some ice. As you can see, mine is melted, but hey. Some filtered water, and then a glass to put it in. To make your infused water, just take your water and pour it into your glass. I put it halfway so it doesn't overflow when I put the fruit in. And then I'm gonna take my raspberries and just drop them on in there. I put 5 of them in there, I think, but you can put more if you want to. And it also depends on how much water you're trying to infuse. And then I put my lemons in and just dropped them on in there with the raspberries. Sorry about my camera skills, y'all. I'm a little shaky. And you don't have to use raspberries or lemons. You can use any fruit you want. This is just my favorite kind. And then I took some mint, my fresh mint, and just pushed it on in there. Just like that. And you don't have to stir it or anything. Then I went ahead and added my ice. After that, my poor little melted ice. And there you go, people. You have infused water. Enjoy.